A group of students took a test. The grades and gender are summarized below. If one student is chosen at random, find the probability that the student was female or got a C on the test. So we want to find the probability that if we select one student, it would be a female or the student would have a C on the test. These two events can occur at the same time since there are some females that also received a C on the test. And therefore, these events are not mutually exclusive, and therefore we'll have to apply this probability formula here for the probability of the union of two events when they're not mutually exclusive. This probability is equal to the probability of selecting a female plus the probability of a student receiving a C minus the probability of a student being a female and receiving a C. We'll be able to tell from the table why we have to subtract this probability here. Notice from the table, looking at the total, 65 students took the test. And notice this row here gives us information about the females. Notice how there were a total of 25 females that took the test, and therefore the probability of selecting a female from this group would be equal to 25 divided by 65 plus, now we want the probability that a student selected at random would have a C on the test. That information is given in this column here. Notice how 12 of the students in the class received a C. And therefore, the probability of selecting a student that received a C would be 12 65ths, or 12 divided by 65. But now notice how we counted these 9 female students that also received a C. These students here in both probabilities. And that's the reason why we have to subtract the probability of a student being a female and a C. We can't count them twice to get the correct probability. So the probability of a student being a female and receiving a C would be equal to 9 divided by 65. So the probability of one student being selected and the student being a female or receiving a C would be equal to 25 65ths plus 12 65ths minus 9 65ths. Notice how we have a common denominator of 65, and the numerator is 25 plus 12, which is 37, minus 9, which is 28, which does not simplify, so this would be our exact probability. Let's also express this as a decimal and percentage. To convert to a decimal, we'll divide. We have 28 divided by 65. Let's round to 4 decimal places. This would be approximately 0.4308. The 6 indicates we round up. As a percentage, this would be 43.08%. So just remember that this is the exact probability, and these two have been rounded, so they're approximations. I hope you found this helpful.